Okay, so we're going to start with the next session, use cases and the technologies for integrating Magnolia with Alfresco. You've probably seen my face in the program as well as my name. I'm Axel Faust. I work for Prodyner, which is a service integrator in Germany, based in Frankfurt basically, but with offices around Germany as well as in Basel here locally. We are basically a service integrator company, IT consulting company, focused on the integration of the customer's enterprise applications within the entire infrastructure. So one aspect of this is Alfresco as a document management, enterprise content management system, as well as other open source solutions like Magnolia or even Liferay. Myself, I'm the head of the content management department or branch of Prodyner, and I'm responsible for all of our Alfresco projects as well as integration solutions with other products. For those of you who may not know Alfresco that much, very few words about Alfresco. Basically, it's the counterpart of Magnolia in the enterprise content management area, focusing on document management, records management, collaboration around documents, the entire internal business processes surrounding your central document assets or business content. It's open source, it has a community version as well as a subscription-based enterprise edition, and it is also available as a cloud-based service from Alfresco itself. Why would Alfresco be useful in being integrated with Magnolia? Basically, one aspect that it provides, which is something that Magnolia doesn't offer at the moment and which is kind of complementary, is the ability to support the collaboration processes within a company. So for example, when we have Alfresco deployed on-premise, we have so-called sites, workspaces, where people and employees can work together on specific tasks, specific projects, organize their collaboration using task lists, wikis, and even small workflows, dynamic workflows. And we also have the Alfresco cloud-based service, which is a service hosted by Alfresco itself, which allows us to connect our on-premise installation with the cloud-based service to, for example, synchronize our business documents to the cloud and make it accessible for our external parties, external partners, for example, an ad agency or our customers or even our partners in terms of implementation partners. And this cloud service even provides integration with several cloud services, so we can use it to enhance our business value of the collaboration without having to grant access to our secure content management service within our on-premise system. We can just synchronize the documents to the cloud, have all the metadata attached to it, transferred to it, and when the work is done, synchronize it back with all the versions intact, with all the metadata intact. And this is something that's going to be useful in integrating with Magnolia, because Magnolia doesn't offer that rich collaboration functionality as of yet. And specific use cases for such an integration, as I said before, collaboration is an important aspect centered around the context of collaborating around the assets used in a document in experience management. Basically, most often you have Magnolia as a system dedicated for web experience management, web content management. You have your groups of authors, publishers with direct access to the content, the assets stored in Magnolia, but the process around creating those assets, updating them when updates are due, usually involves a lot of other personnel, people in the company as well, subject matter experts, for example, the marketing department, or even external ad agencies. And these usually don't have direct access to the Magnolia instance and can't contribute their assets directly to that. So for example, you could have a collaboration workflow where an editor or author of Magnolia decides that some specific asset needs to be updated. And since you can't do the update or the collaboration process using this asset in Magnolia itself, he has to contribute it to some other system, external system, to be able to share it with the subject matter expert, the marketing department, and external agency. Historically, these tools of choice for such an integration or such a collaboration were emails, Dropbox-based file sharing systems, network drives, every kind of IT software that is kind of a nightmare for IT governance, because you lose your entire connection between the asset in Magnolia and the content, the file on those services. For example, you lose metadata for as one example, you lose the version history of those assets, and you may even lose control over who has access to these assets. And using Alfresco in such a scenario to kind of support this collaboration flow for the external parties helps to secure this whole process and provide added value, for example, using the services of Alfresco to enhance the flow between them, for example, for conversion of documents from one format to another. Another use case would be kind of a passive use where some users in the external system, for example in Alfresco, have created specific assets for their day-to-day work, for their daily needs. It may be a data sheet or a presentation for a customer that's been, there was a meeting, and they want to supply these assets to the document to the web content management team to use in the external presence of the company. For example, publishing new data sheets as they become available from the project development team. So there's also use case, a possibility that these people want to submit the assets and want to have a review workflow around these assets. So not everything is published at once. So there's checks and balances in the Magnolia instance so that authors and publishers have the say in what it gets published and what needs to be reworked before it's being published. And the other way around would be that authors and editors, publishers, actively search the external system, Alfresco, for content that might be useful in enhancing and elaborating the web presence of the company. Now, when we talk about integrating Alfresco with Magnolia, we have to talk about the APIs available in both systems and how they could be used to integrate those two systems and what problems may arise. Basically, the two major kinds of interfaces available in both platforms are CMIS, Content Management Interoperability Services, and REST-like APIs, which are basically proprietary APIs of both systems that expose, in Magnolia, for example, access to content, to nodes, to properties, as well as commands. In Alfresco, basically everything is based on a REST API because Alfresco already separates UI from the backend and they talk together with REST. Those two interfaces have different purposes. Content Management Interoperability Services, which is kind of mouthful, is used to integrate on a document management level, while REST can be used to integrate kind of any kind of asset, any kind of entity that you want to expose via REST-like interface. So you can basically expose any business service, business entity you have in your systems. And this can be used to kind of add on to the CMI space to provide a full API for your system. Those two services, those two APIs, have a couple of problems that you need to be aware of if you want to use them to integrate Alfresco with Magnolia or other kind of CMIS-based application. CMS has a major issue. Basically, it's the everyone integrate with me syndrome, as I like to call it, because every other CMIS-based repository only provides the capability to be accessed by CMIS-based clients, but no system provides client-based access to other systems. For example, Alfresco doesn't provide an out-of-the-box capability to access Magnolia via CMS, and the other way around too. So there's a problem everyone wants to be integrated with, but no one provides the full feature set to be integrated. We also have currently a kind of transition phase when it comes to Magnolia with the CMIS module. The CMIS module in Magnolia 4 was for the document management workspace, and it's now not yet been adapted to the digital asset management workspace. And some key aspects of the typical document management domain are not yet covered. For example, tagging is not uniformly covered, and the creation of renditions of specific documents are not yet supported in the standard. REST, on the other side, has also a couple of problems, a couple of issues that are problematic for any integration. Typically, most of the API provided via REST is internal API. Internal in such a way that either it's used by the platform itself, as is in the case with Alfresco, where the user interface of Alfresco uses the REST API to access the services, or it's internal in terms of that it's specific to that platform, it's proprietary basically, and it can change from version to version. It's not stable enough for full-featured integration. Parameters and conditions of operations on REST are difficult to discover for clients to provide a kind of user interface to the user without having to code too much. And there's also a problem using identifiers between CMIS and RESTful. CMIS has a specific way of identifying objects, identifying documents, and the identifiers used in REST interfaces usually are business-oriented identifiers specific to that domain and don't have to map to the identifiers used in CMIS. So there's an issue of a disconnect there that the identifiers can't be exchanged, and this is can be problematic for several clients when they want to integrate REST-based services and CMIS-based services. What we as ProDyna have developed in the last couple of months is a hybrid integration of Alfresco with Magnolia, which is something that I'm going to be showcasing in just a few slides. And basically, it follows the concept that we want to use best of both worlds. So we want to provide a new CMS client service core in Magnolia and want to flesh out the functionality use necessary for these use cases I presented earlier, using RESTful add-ons, RESTful actions on both sides, on Alfresco as well as Magnolia, to kind of flesh out the API for them to integrate. Both platforms should be active participants in that integration, so we don't have just a integration that is dominated by Magnolia or dominated by Alfresco. Each one of them can actively initiate processes, interactions with the other one. And one major requirement for us for our internal development was that it would be reusable, adaptable. Basically, the CMS core, the CMS services we wanted to provide should be reusable for other CMS-based repositories. So not just Alfresco, but for example, SharePoint, Documentum, any kind of repository that uses CMS or provides CMS services. And we want to make it pluggable so that you can plug in support for specifics of these platforms later on, for example, authentication specifics, metadata mapping, anything and such. And now to the short demo. It's going to be a bit weird because I can't clone my screen at the moment. So I just have to put it up here and kind of switch around. So what we have here is basically an Alfresco in a VM and a Magnolia based on my local system. And let's say we have a user called John Doe. He is a Magnolia user, and he is one of the editors of a Magnolia site. And he's responsible for preparing the assets for the relaunch, for example, of our main corporate website. And he needs to collect specific assets from the different departments of our company, for example, enterprise open source solutions and content management. In the presentations folder, he already has a presentation about a webinar we had a couple of weeks ago together with Magnolia, but it's just the prepared slides, not the final slides. And he needs to retrieve the finalized slides from the people in Alfresco that have access to it and may be able to update them. So we can initiate collaboration with Alfresco. These are already data collected from Alfresco. For example, this is the specific workspace in Alfresco where the user is a member of and has access to and can initiate the process in. And just says, okay, please provide the I hope I don't make too many typing mistakes. Finalized slides and metadata, for example. It should be due on 29th. And if it's done, he wants to be informed about the review, or he wants to be involved in the review. Now that document is transferred to Alfresco. It takes a while depending on how good the internal network works. I just tried it yesterday, okay. And in Alfresco, we have another user, for example, Jane Smith from the subject department, subject area. She has access to the site as well, to the Solution Content Center Content Management, which is a workspace in Alfresco. And that workspace already contains a kind of overview of things she has to do, for example, collaboration requests coming from Magnolia that need to be processed. For example, we have the Magnolia Open Suite webinar slides that are provided by Magnolia. She can preview it using the standard Alfresco functionality, can access the metadata of that document, can edit it. And if you go, for example, in the document view, there's also kind of hints for this document. For example, that it's due on that date, it's a new document, and the request is to please provide the finalized slides. So what I want to do here is just upload a new version of the slides. It's really kind of weird doing this turn back. And I had hoped he would open the folder directly. I have the finalized slides as a PDF, for example. And I just want to do a major update, minor update, or major update. Okay, the document has been updated now. It's now a PDF, although the document name still says PowerPoint presentation due to the metadata. But it's a PDF which is now rendered for view in Alfresco. And we want to edit the metadata in Alfresco as well, so we can provide it back to Magnolia. we're just going to do the basic metadata, because editing the full metadata may take a while, and it's not useful for the demo here. But basically, we just edit the title, because it's not really useful that as a title. It's the OpenSuite webinar, and didn't do any. Just want to save the metadata. And now when the action is done, she wants to submit that change back to Magnolia for review, for inclusion, and can also provide a comment for it. For example, okay, just do a simple comment. And since John Doe said he wanted to be informed about the review, he now has a collaboration task and a work item for that collaboration. And you can view the original asset, view the document in a CMS repository, so in Alfresco, before he actually imports it. You can view it via a new CMS browser that we provide as an app. In Alfresco, you can view the metadata, can actually view the content. Since Magnolia doesn't provide an out-of-the-box PDF viewer, you can open it. Oop-a-la. That did not happen yesterday evening. Sorry for that. But basically can access the metadata, can access even the renditions of the document, and we can try another document later on so show that it works. This is something that is new to me, the problem, and can see the metadata before it actually decides on that topic. And you can even reject the issue, review, request changes to the document, or say we accept it and import it to a document, to the asset space of Magnolia. In the background, it's now being imported, and if you go to the Assets app, it's already open because I've been here before. We now see the updated metadata mapped to Magnolia. If we were to provide additional metadata in Alfresco, for example, Dublin Core, that would also be able to be mapped back to Magnolia to the specific JCR properties of the asset. And we can also look at the versions which are automatically created by the collaboration process. So we have an initial version if the document didn't have one before, and the version for the actual update imported from Alfresco. And the workflow, the use case, the other way around for active submission from Alfresco is pretty simple as well. When we go into the Solution Center workspace, we have, for example, a marketing folder with a couple of documents here. You can see some of my tests from last night just to make sure it works. For example, we have a data sheet that needs to be provided to the asset workspace in Magnolia for inclusion in the website, and the user can just submit this document to Magnolia for review and potential inclusion. And based on configuration within Magnolia, specific user group is assigned a work item to review that. In this demo, it's the same user, John Doe. And again, he can view the CMS document before importing. And by importing, you can select where to import the document to. Let's do it in data sheets. And I'll just leave the comment empty for now. It's not required. And again, metadata and content are automatically imported and mapped to, automatically imported to Magnolia. So if you go into the data sheet here, we actually have additional metadata in the Alfresco document. We have some Dublin Core metadata, basic data, not really realistic ones, but they are already mapped to Magnolia. And one other app that we added, you have seen it before when viewing the assets or the documents before importing, is a CMS browser, which allows us to browse any external CMS repository, for example Alfresco, fully using the CMS services in the background, and can access any kind of document here as well. For example, go into the Solution Center space again, where I have access to, and for example, actively import a document as well, not just have them submitted. We can import it into the Assets app directly. Again, including the metadata and creating versions where applicable. So far for the short demo showcase of the integration, most of the work actually has been done in the background making this integration possible. And basically it's providing a CMS-based core for the CMS browser to build upon, as well as the processes and the commands that actually import Exchange documents with Alfresco. So we have developed a couple of modules for Magnolia, which add CMS client functionality within the Magnolia platform, Magnolia 5 platform, and it's separated into a common client domain, as well as additional modules dedicated to mapping. We want to add a synchronization module later on as well, and the actual CMS browser app. And we also have additional optional plugins which can kind of provide the specific CMS services. So we basically just define an API in those two modules, and a specific implementation module adds the actual implementation, the actual services here based on OpenCMS from Apache, which is used to integrate with Alfresco. All of these modules can be configured in to some extent. For example, we can configure the different connectors to CMS-based services. We can have multiple CMS repositories accessed via Magnolia, as well as multiple servers, not just repositories. This is done via the connector and server configuration. Also, we have configuration of the logic for the mapping, so we can say which CMS metadata attribute maps to which JCR metadata attribute. And the CMS browser application is basically just a standard content app. I say standard in quotation marks because we had to do a couple of adjustments to make it not depend on the JCR backend of Magnolia itself. As I said before, we provide a service abstraction that makes it possible to use the CMS module in Magnolia without having to rely on the Apache Chemistry implementation behind it, or even use an additional other implementation besides Apache Chemistry. And you may have seen in the last slide the term session aspect for the service factory. Session aspects are our way of configuring and modifying the connection to a CMS-based repository. And it's actually just used for the CMS session setup, for example, defining the host and the binding of the CMS repository, dealing with authentication if you're using a single sign-on, or using a defined user, for example, for Magnolia to connect to Alfresco, and other aspects like caching, proxying, or compression methods on the HTTP connection. An example aspect would be external authentication, or kind of single sign-on authentication, where Alfresco trusts Magnolia to already authenticate the user correctly and uses the user information provided by Magnolia in a pre-setup REST call to create a user ticket that Magnolia can then use to create the actual CMS connection based on the functionality that Alfresco provides around user tickets. And we can even put in an optional step of verifying that Magnolia actually is the client being used against Alfresco by using SSL certificates for validation purposes. Configuration is standard and pretty straightforward in a JCR way. For example, here we define the connection to a CMS server, local Alfresco, the base URL, and using the chemistry Alfresco admin service factory, we define the connection parameters, how the session should be set up. And basically we say here, it's in this case a session factory that uses defined authentication. All accesses are always executed as admin on the Alfresco server. We have a specific binding and also implementation of the service class. And this can be modified to your liking depending on which CMS repository you want to integrate with, not just Alfresco. Now, in terms of meta model mapping, I've said before, it's fully configurable in terms of which JCR properties are mapped to which CMS properties and the other way around. The elements responsible for providing this mapping functionality is a mapping service, central mapping service in the CMS mapping module, which has a set of configured rules, which can be composite rules to include complex constellations in one definition, and which may be applicable to specific use cases, specific conditions, for example, for specific JCR node types. Basically focusing, for example, just on assets, or for specific CMS object types on the other side as well. And the applicability of a specific mapping rule is determined by evaluating the mapping context, and you can even provide an arbitrary context information. For example, you can provide the context of your action where you call the mapping service from to have a specific application definition, evaluate that context to say if a mapping rule is applicable or not. And we can map all kinds of information. We can map the primary type information and the secondary type information, mixins or expecs on Alfresco side, binary data, as well as any kind of property. Currently, we do not yet support the mapping of relationships between those two systems, but this is planned. And configuration is simple as well. For example, here we have a general name rule, which is always applicable. We have a general digital asset management asset rule, which is only applicable for node types of Magnolia asset. And even specific workspaces can be restricted or other object types on the CMIS side. And we also have some local Alfresco rules, which are only applicable if the CMIS system being talked to is Alfresco in that instance. And yeah, so you can highly customize your mapping rules depending on which system you integrate with. In terms of the REST interaction, there's a kind of a bit disparity between Alfresco and Magnolia. Alfresco already uses REST extensively internally, so they already have some facilities to perform REST calls to other systems, which is at the moment lacking in Magnolia. But fortunately, Magnolia already includes a couple of libraries that we can simply use to add in that functionality. For the interaction, as a kind of a overview of the scheme of interaction, for the demo I just showed you, basically we have an initiation of the actual collaboration process from Magnolia to Alfresco, where the context of the collaboration is set up. Alfresco responds with the context where the document should be uploaded to, and this is then done via CMIS. And at certain points, the actual triggers for specific actions are always performed via REST, while the data transfer is performed using CMIS. So after a while, the Alfresco user triggers the review, and when the review is satisfied with the result, he can notify the completion after the asset has been imported via CMIS. The basic framework we've added to enable the RESTful integration of Magnolia with Alfresco is basically a couple of additional Magnolia modules at the moment focused around the Alfresco REST API, where we provide abstract service facades for the generic REST call, as well as service facades for some specific REST calls, for example, to retrieve information about the structured data forms available in Alfresco. We're doing this using the JAX-RS interface and the REST Easy client. The REST Easy client is not officially shipped with Magnolia, but I think a slight overview in the packaging has led to it being included due to test purposes. But the REST Easy client integrates pretty nicely with the REST Easy server already included with Magnolia. And in terms for the kind of triggers for actions on both sides of the integration on Magnolia and Alfresco, we're using the same style of functionality. On Magnolia, they are called commands. In Alfresco, they're called actions. Or we can even use the term remote forms, because Alfresco already provides kind of a structured definition for these forms to be used in Alfresco in Magnolia to provide a user interface for these actions. The additional modules for the REST interaction with Alfresco are basically plug-in modules to the existing CMIS client and CMIS browser application. So we provide just additional actions within that view, within the asset view, that are built upon the existing CMIS functionality. And Alfresco core UI and chemistry just provide the additional functionality required, for example, for authentication against Alfresco or for mapping the CMIS identifiers to the RESTful identifiers necessary for the call to Alfresco. And one thing I already mentioned is the ability of Alfresco to provide a kind of structured definition of a specific form for an action for a remote command. And this is useful for us in Magnolia to be able to provide generic dynamic user interfaces for a specific user action in Alfresco without having to go in and reconfigure Magnolia every time an action in Alfresco changes. So we can adapt to changes made to the Alfresco systems without having to change Magnolia. And any action that wants to perform a remote action in Alfresco can just call the Alfresco services responsible for the structured form, retrieve the form definition, and then create all the assets required in Java, the Vardin item, as well as the Magnolia form definition dynamically based on that definition, and even mix in some custom fields, for example, required for some tracking of an action in Magnolia itself. For example, the collaboration initiated from Magnolia is tracked in Magnolia, so every couple of days or hours, Magnolia could also check actively about the status of the collaboration without having to rely on feedback from Alfresco. And this is done by using some custom fields that are stored in Magnolia in addition to the fields being submitted. When the dialogue for action is finished in Magnolia, the form data is collected based on the Magnolia form definition as well as the Alfresco form definition and submitted back to Alfresco to execute the action eventually. So far for the technical kind of sweet bits of the implementation, there are a couple more issues or a couple more aspects that may be interesting to some of you, but these are the core issues that I wanted to present in this aspect, because CMS and REST are the core of this integrations. Before I go to the question and answer sections, a couple of conclusions and final remarks about the integration we did with Magnolia and Alfresco. One is in terms of how kind of difficult or how much effort actually went into the integration. Integrating any kind of system via CMS is pretty easy based on the services and libraries provided by Apache OpenCMS, but integrating a CMS-based interface in Magnolia proved a bit more difficult than we expected due to some dependencies on JCR in the front end. But as far as I remember the keynote from today, it's being solved in Magnolia 5.3. So kind of bad luck there that we just started with 5.2, but it will improve in the future. And the two things we most missed in our integration and that we want to have for further development of that integration to provide a more enhanced, more full-fledged feature set is a CMS module update on Magnolia, so we can have Alfresco actively call Magnolia, browse in the assets in Magnolia, fetch them for some collaboration without the editors having to initiate the process, and then start the submit process right from the updated asset in Alfresco. And what would also be useful for providing a UI in Alfresco for Magnolia commands would be a way that the commands could expose their parameters to an outside client, so the client can automatically create a user interface, just like we do in Magnolia for the Alfresco actions. This is two most aspects that we miss and we want to have in future versions to make it a full-fledged solution. What's improbable for the future is that we will be able to provide a full decoupling of identifiers between CMS and REST. This is something that's basically impossible because it depends on the collaboration of every kind of CMS repository provider to unify their interfaces, CMS with REST, and use the same kind of identifiers. And it will probably never be possible to use one identifier or one document on all interfaces. Just some final remarks about the platform we use. I said it in the beginning, it's Magnolia 5.2, basically more precise, 5.22. And the Alfresco platform in use was Alfresco 4.2, but the additions, the modifications we made to Alfresco are already are downward compatible to at least Alfresco 4.0. So any newer Alfresco version since, I think, 2 or 3 years ago, since 4.0 was released, should be compatible with that edition. Our plan is to provide the basic modules where the showcase I demoed earlier is based on as open source modules to the community and provide some additional enterprise modules that have more functionality, more enterprise prepared workflows, for example, so more enterprise features later on. We don't have yet a time plan or time release schedule for these modules, but we do plan to do it within the span of this summer of this year, so stay tuned for any information about the modules in this year. So, okay, now that I'm finished with my remarks, thanks for your attention and I look forward to your questions.